copy of Ramcharitmanas and is to hide it. He is to tell Gurudev, don't read it too much. Because Ram story is also very attractive, you get drawn to Ram. But Gurudev had so much love and affection for Ram. In fact, he had darshan of Sita Ram, Lakshman Hanuman, Ram Darbar. And whenever he used to speak the Harikatha of Ram, tears used to flow from his eyes. When Gurudev went one time preaching in America to boys Idaho, there so many Ram Bhaktas were there. And guess what? They said, Gurudev gave us Diksha Mantras. And Gurudev gave everyone Ram Mantra, not Krishna Mantra. That's what I heard. Anyways, Gurudev is all powerful. So, by Gurudev's mercy, I think we have come here. So, Rama and Ravan tried every means to kill Ram. All means were unsuccessful. Finally, Ravan thought, I'll call my brother. He called very powerful brother. He had two brothers, Ahiravan and Mahiravan. So he called Ahiravan. Hey Ahiravan, you have to devise a way and you have to get rid of this Ram and Lakshman. So Ahiravan said, no problem. It's very easy for me because I can take any shape. Vibhishan knew that Ahiravan is very, very powerful. So Vibhishan warned Hanuman that be very carefully guard Ram and Lakshman. Ahiravan may come in any shape and he may try to kill Ram and Lakshman. So that time Hanuman, by using his tail, he created a fort like structure and kept Ram and Lakshman hidden in that fort of his own tail. As you know that Hanuman is serving Bhagwan Ram in so many ways. Hanuman is the chariot of Ram and Lakshman. Where was the chariot of Ram and Lakshman? They had no chariots. Later on, Indra sent one chariot at a final hour. But previously, no chariot. Hanuman was the chariot. If Ram and Lakshman are feeling any sun, too much sun is burning their skin, then Hanuman will raise his tail, it will become umbrella. If then Ram and Lakshman are feeling too much heat, then Hanuman's tail will act like a fan. So, Hanuman is doing so many seva. So now Hanuman's tail is so long, it became like a fort. And he had hidden Ram and Lakshman. And Vibhishan told, don't let anyone come inside this fort. He told Hanuman, only I should be allowed. So Ahiravan knew this. Secretly had heard this. So Ahiravan, it took shape of the Vibhishan and told Hanuman that watch out for Ahiravan. And in the shape of Vibhishan he entered. Hanuman could not recognize him. He was covered by the Maya of Ahiravan. And he entered and he kidnapped Ram and Lakshman and took them to the lower planetary system. So Hanuman finally, then real Vibhishan came. And real Vibhishan said, hey Hanuman, where are Ram and Lakshman? I thought you only had come previously. No, I did not come. It was Ahiravan who has taken Ram and Lakshman. So now go and search for them. So Hanuman came searching, could not find on the earth planet. So he entered the lower planetary system. Because demons, they live in the lower planetary system. Understand? Upper planetary system is very opulent, Swarga Loka. But even more opulent is the Vila Swarga. There is actually Divi Swarga, higher Swarga Loka, there is Bhu Swarga, and there is also Vila Swarga, the lower planetary system, they are also very opulent. So that is where the demons live, Ahiravan had taken Ram and Lakshman there. He had made them unconscious by his mystic power. They were senseless, Ram and Lakshman. And he had put their bodies and bathed them, dressed in a fresh cloth and about to do sacrifice. And he had taken a sword in his hand. Hanuman saw all this and hid behind the deity of Kali. And he took a shape of a small fly, like a mosquito. You know? Hanuman has Siddhi. He can become Anima and Lagima. Anima means to be smaller than an atom. And Lagima means he can become taller than the sky. Ishita, Gurutva, he can become heavier than a mountain, Mahima. So all these siddhis he has, Ashta Siddhi. So Hanuman became very small like this and hid behind the deity of Kali. And when the opportune time came, he was about to slaughter Ram and Lakshman. He grabbed the sword from his hand and he actually slaughtered Ahiravan like a goat, you know, chopped off his head. And then, bringing Ram and Lakshman to consciousness, he came immersed from the earth at this same place. So do you see the Hanuman deity here? It's not carved by anyone, it's self-manifesting.
So
the big Hanuman, you see, the big deity is there. So Hanuman Maharaj is telling that Hanuman is who? He is actually Shankara Subhana Kesari Nandana, Deja Pratapa Mahajagavata. Lord Shiva himself has taken shape of Hanumanji. So Lord Shiva thought that this body of me is not suitable to serve Ram. Especially Lord Shiva has Ekadash Rudra form. But that is not suitable. So our Hanumanji, he became Hanuman. And he was serving Ram in so many ways. So many ways. So any pastime of Krishna, Lord Shiva will be there. You say, is Krishna, is he there in Vrindavan? When Krishna became cowherd boy, then Lord Shiva used to come to Yashoda Bhavan, used to come in Nanda Bhavan, in Gokul, and used to tell, I want to see Krishna. Mother Yashoda would be very scared because Lord Shiva would be having so many snakes, so many dreadlocks. But Krishna would weep. Mother Yashoda had to bring out Krishna, baby Krishna. Also then he developed the greed to dance with Krishna, to see Krishna's rasa dance. He became Gopishwar Maharaj. Also when Krishna became Dwarkadish, so Hanuman is always there with him. He became Bhima. Who's Bhima? He's Hanuman only. But then Krishna came, and in Kali Yuga, Hanuman again came as Madhvacharya. So Hanuman actually he is the son of Vayu. Gurudev says that he is the Vayu avatar. What is Vayu? Vayu is serving. Vayu means prana. Vayu means prana. So prana means we have five life years in our body. Prana, vyan, saman, upan, udan. But the mukhya prana is Hanuman. Without prana, can you live? As soon as your prana will go, atma will come out, paramatma will also come out. So it means this mukhya prana is very important. What is mukhya prana? In Vaikuntha planet, Lord Narayan is sitting. Gurudev has written this in his book, Jar Sampradaya, Four Sampradaya. So Lord Narayan is sitting in Vaikuntha, and in his left thigh, Lakshmi is sitting. And in his right thigh, Mukhya Prana is sitting. Prana Deva, Prana Vayu, Prana Devata. That Prana incarnated in Kali Yuga as Madhvacharya. As in Treta Yuga appeared as Hanuman. In Dwapara Yuga appeared as Bhima. And also in Mahaprabhu's pastimes, Hanuman came as Shri Murari Gupta. And Mahaprabhu persuaded him, oh, you worship Lord Krishna, Lord Krishna. But he could not. Also Advaita Acharya is also Lord Shiva. So Shiva Tattva, Shiva himself has become Hanuman. But Ravan, what he did? Ravan was the greatest devotee of Lord Shiva. So much so that he was going to cut off all his heads and offer to sacrifice to Shiva. Shiva became so pleased with Ravan, gave him so many validations. But Shiva told him, you return Sita, then I'll be very favorable to you. But he did not follow the order of Shiva. So Hanuman, Shiva came in the shape of Hanuman and punched Ravan. And even in the daytime, Lord, by the punch of Hanuman, Ravan saw the stars in the eyes, stars in the daytime, and he fainted. So you see that Hanuman, he is always in pastimes of Bhagavan. So bol Hanuman ji ki, Sita Ram Lakshman Hanuman ki, I got my man.
चल हरे कृष्ण हम लोग अभी जाएंगे जहाँ पर सूत्र सौनकादि संवाद जहाँ पर सूत्र गोस्वामी ने सौनकादि ऋषियों का प्रश्न का उत्तर दिया है जहाँ पर सौनकादि ऋषियों ने छह प्रश्न किया है वहाँ पर जाएंगे और रीता गौर ब्रह्मानंदे हरे हरे चलो